Hello, welcome to Discovery. Today I'm going to talk to you about changing the stylus on a record player. We have a record player here. It's an Elta brand with a built-in radio that a customer has left in. And you can see here where the stylus arm, and that is, I'm going to just gently push this over so that I can tip it up on its side. I'll show you right there how the needle is broken. The replacement one, to give you an idea, is going to look like that. So this is the replacement, this is the damaged one, and we're going to show you how exactly you replace them as well. So, let's give it a shot. Okay, so here's our record player ready to have its stylus replaced. I got the needle here at the end of the arm. What I want to do is, I want to give it a little bit of support by putting my finger underneath, because there is going to be some pressure involved. I'm going to use my thumbnail to unclip the housing here. With a little bit of force. There we go, we've loosened it. And it's such a way then that you just simply pull it forward, it hinges away, and comes out. Now, all I need to do is get my replacement, which is right here. You can see it's identical to the damaged one. And we'll just gently take that out. These are very durable little pieces, but at the same time, you don't want to be applying any kind of abuse to them as well. Now, you do have to be careful when you go to put these on, because you don't want that little metal arm, which has a diamond tip right at the very heart of that there, that's what your pickup is, you don't want that to get damaged. You can see here on the stylus, this little protruding piece here, that's what's going to pick up the metal wire's vibrations, that metal arm's vibrations, to carry it to the amplifier and therefore produce the sound that you hear from the record. So again, giving it a little bit of support. A little bit closer. I can somewhat try putting it up that it's almost in a hinged position. You feel a little bit of a click. You get a gentle push in, and that should be it. And the next part is to test it. Okay, so we have the unit powered on. Just to let you know as well that this unit is has got built-in speakers in the front here. It's got a built-in radio as well, just to let you know. So it's very handy. I don't have to plug it into the in-house power amplifier system. So putting this back here, we need to test it. We've got our needle put in. We need to find out, does it work? So what better record to try to give it a shot with than maybe some Queen? Don't stop me now from Queen, the original 1978 7-inch single. Here we are. It's a favorite for a lot of people. I'm going to give it a shot. For a 7-inch single, most of these would have been pressed at a playing speed of 45. So select the player there to 45. It's on. It'll auto start as I swing in the arm and let it fall down gently at the start. See what happens and turn up the volume. Tonight, I'm gonna have myself. I think that's pretty much a success, so hopefully that little bit of a tip is very good for you, give you an idea. Of course, I can get the styluses and needles for many makes and models, and if you'd like to me to have a fit on one that you have, if it's giving you some problem, bring it down here into the mall in William Street, and I'll have a look at it for you as well.